There is a gap between expectations and the actual possibilities. The idea is for complete devices, cars, cell phones, to come out of the printer, which at the moment is, of course, neither possible nor foreseeable.
Our vision is to develop this additive manufacturing process in such a way that we can actually print a model created in the CAD system, getting it right the first time and printing it perfectly. We call this the first time right principle, which we want to achieve here.
We can use this technology to produce geometries that are very complex that I'd never be able to make in the conventional way by turning, milling or drilling.
As Siemens, we are a pioneer in the implementation of the additive manufacturing process and are already using this process commercially for the production of gas turbine components and spare parts for trains. As things currently stand in technical terms, I need to take an iterative approach to find the right solution. That means I need to vary the printing parameters to ultimately achieve the desired geometry and corresponding material properties. This does not usually work the first time.
The most common errors that occur while printing metal are local overheating and distortion, which make a component either impossible to manufacture or useless.
On the one hand, we have machines in our lab which we use to print prototypes in order to gain hands-on experience with typical error patterns, while on the other hand, we also engage in process simulation to predict if the component characteristics are within the specifications.
We are currently developing the digital data chain at Siemens. This allows me to virtually optimize the process before actually printing the component.
If you say simply follow the trace of the laser, the calculations would probably take 2,000 years. And that's actually the surprising thing, that we found an alternative way to simulate a component in perhaps an hour instead of 2,000 years. The next step will be for the software to detect errors that can occur during the process to the extent that a warning or an automatic correction takes place.
At Siemens, we have already taken a step in the direction of the first-time right principle with the help of research and development. We are much closer to our goal of providing a robust process. At the end of the day, the manufacturing robustness decides whether my production is economically worthwhile.